All right, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Joe Chapin with 3M. We're going to talk about passive optical LAN today, the components, benefits, some myths, and a couple of pretty impressive case studies. Okay, what is passive optical LAN? Passive optical LAN is GPON. Verizon Fios, same thing, same architecture. 20 million endpoints installed today. Rapid return on investment, lower total cost of ownership at often half the cost of a copper network. It eliminates your IDF closets and is considered green technology, all done over a single mode fiber. Why do you want to choose passive optical LAN? All passives between the actives being the OLT and the ONT, there are no active components requiring no power. You can get committed bandwidth, centralized management. An example of that, this entire hotel could be managed from a single OLT the size of a microwave, the entire network. You can reduce or eliminate your IDFs, you have less physical cable, you're future-proof, and you also have superior performance. And in most cases, you can get up to 70% less capital, 80% less operating, and 90% space savings if you use passive optical LAN over copper. Okay, this is the POL architecture. What you have here on the left is your OLT, optical line terminal. This is the brain of your network. It goes in the MDF next to your router. From there, you have a backbone on a single mode fiber of 2.4 gigabits down, 1.2 up, and there's a third channel at 1550 nanometers for RF and QAM video, voice video data. Once you go to that, you hit your splitter, and you split a single fiber up to 32 ways. And very important to remember, when you split the fiber, you do not split the bandwidth. Bandwidth remains the same until you get to the endpoint where you have your ONTs. And then from the ONT, you have a copper Cat5 jack to your endpoint, whether it be a computer, analog phone, Wi-Fi access point security, or video. Again, voice video data, mostly fiber. Fiber from here to here, last little bit is copper. For a network that is less money, less energy, less space. Here's a side-by-side comparison. This is your copper, this is your fiber. With your copper network, you have your router, you have your distance limited here to 100 meters, and then when you get your multi-mode fiber, you can go 550 meters or 100 meters with copper. With passive optical LAN, 20 to 30 kilometers without regenerating the signal. You no longer have Ethernet switches. You have your OLT at the start, have your splitters out in the zone, then you have your ONT at the end. Okay, 300 times greater reach, up to 18 miles. If you're 20 to 30 kilometers, 30 kilometers if you do a 1 to 16 split, 20 kilometers if you do a 1 to 32 split. Okay? Here's some disadvantages of copper. Ethernet services are the same for 15 to 20 years, basic same architecture. Ethernet is more expensive, requires more power, requires more space. A typical Ethernet with 2016 users requires 90 rack units. POL serving 7,700 users requires one. Okay? Greater scalability, again, this is for less energy, less space, less money. Doesn't require copper upgrades. You can upgrade your POL from a 2.4 gig to a 10 gig by swapping out a card in the OLT, and they are on different wavelengths. You can have simultaneous 2.4 G and 10 G networks on your passive optical LAN. Okay, if you remember no other slide, remember this one. What changes? This is your typical copper network. Router, switch, multi-mode fiber, access switches, Cat5 drops. Okay, when you go to POL, get rid of your distribution switch and your multi-mode fibers. Get rid of your access switches, you don't need those anymore. Because you get rid of your access switches, you don't need IDFs anymore, so you get rid of your HVAC, your fire suppression, and your backup power. Okay, get rid of your Cat5 runs. Again, those are limited to 100 meters. Get rid of your heavy-duty cable trays. POL. Put in your OLT, that's your brain, MDF, single mode fiber, out to your splitters. In this particular case, they're splitting four ways, then eight ways, splitting it twice because it comes out of the OLT too hot in some cases. Put in your long fiber runs, like up to 20 kilometers, light duty cable trays, lightweight cable trays, Cat5 drops. Okay, the network you saw at the beginning was 2,500 users with copper. That's 28,000. Less money, less space, less energy. So if you are installing a DAS system in a large building, the space you are going to save by installing your DAS network will allow you to build extra hotel rooms, extra office space, extra supply space for about half the energy use going forward. And you're set because you don't need to replace the fiber. The only thing you're going to replace in maybe 10 years are your OLTs. OLTs are slated to last 28 years per telco standard. So here are the three components of a POL. Optical line terminal, it's the brain, that's about as big as a microwave. These are your ONTs, those are about so big, that's about as big as a Wi-Fi router. Those are your splitters, okay, and those are fairly small as well. Three components. OLT has two main functions, converts electrical to optical signals, and it coordinates the multiplexing between the ONT, the endpoint. So this is the brains of the POL. Most OLTs will support up to 4,000 VLANs. 4,000. Two examples. These are two Telebs OLTs. This one here, 23-inch rack mount, almost 8,200 users. That one there, which is about that size, that'll do 1,024, up to 30 kilometers away. Campus environment's great, large hotels great, stadiums also great. These are another manufacturer. This is Zone. Key points here, small, medium, large. One rack unit, three rack units, eight rack units, 1,024, 7,200, almost 15,000 users. Space savings on a POL. 18 separate 3x3x7 racks. That's 2,000 endpoints. This is one rack, that's 8,000. 90% difference in space. And with less equipment, you're gonna have less heating needs in your MDF as well, and cooling. Tells you what a splitter is. Splitters are the magic in POL, those little black boxes with the plug-ins, the green SC connector plug-ins. Basically, it takes and it splits the signal. No power, no electronics, does not require HVAC. Very scalable, you can plug them in, plug and play. They have what's called cascading, where you split it twice. As long as the signal falls between negative 13 and 26 dB, signal's good. Good to go. These are examples of some of the splitters that we make. You have your inputs there, so you come out of the OLT, plug in there, and it splits it eight ways. Port two splits to eight, port three splits to eight. These are modular. So if you have a network that you want to grow, you can plug in one to start with, and as you grow, you can add them, okay? You can swap out a 1x8 splitter for a 1x16 if you want, or a 1x32, you can scale the splitters. We also have a rack mount as well, if you want to reuse your rack space. Another example, a splitter module, one wide, two wide, three wide. You plug in, self-contained, easily installable. Just another example, this is a wall box, goes between the studs of a building. Plug them in, close it up, lock it, secure. Again, plug in, plug in, plug in. This is a fan out module to start with. Plug in a multiple fiber to start with, fans out into individual fiber. So 12 fiber in, 12 out, and you can cross over to your splitters. All in one space. This is now your IDF, about the size of that. No HVAC again, no power. These are ONTs. Two of your your wall plate ONTs. ONTs will support eight VLANs per port. Okay, so in this particular case, these will support 16 VLANs, two RJ45 ports. You have a 24-port or ONT, that'll be 28 VLANs per port, 20 times 24. Okay? Another example, ONTs, desktop series. This has eight ports, fiber goes in here, your RJ45 comes out. Another example of your Telebs, the zone wall plate ONTs. Here's some advantages. Talked about space. 28,672 users, that's only 2,000 of copper. You go from these two cables here, 48 ports and data ports, 1,500. Imagine that going 20 kilometers of distance, the space savings and the weight you're gonna save. Cost savings, POL, 92,000, Cat6, 176,000. 10-story building, weight savings, with Cat6, 12,000 pounds, POL, 1,200 pounds, 90% less material. On the left, this serves 120 endpoints, those two together, 128 single fiber. Space saving, or the material savings there. Space savings. You guys, I'm sure, have all seen something like this. This is all your copper wires being installed. That's all that's required, POL, the yellow. And as you can see, many advantages. These are the governments that, governmental agencies that have adopted POL. You have the Army, Marine Corps, Air Force, Department of Health Service, Human Services, Department of Energy, the intelligence community. There is a letter that is, by all the military, must have a POL network installed going forward as of 2014 without a, quote, very good reason. Because it is more secure, more energy efficient, and less costly. These are the commercial adoptions we've seen. University of Washington, Deltek, San Diego Library, Intel, Trump Tower. This is one of the myths of POL. They say it's difficult to tap. It's actually not true. It uses what's called an AES 128 encryption, military standard, advanced encryption standard. It is not susceptible to electromagnetic interference, radio interference, or electromagnetic pulse. The major reason why the military is going to passive optical LAN. GPON is a network where all travel to a core switch with a single point of failure. Not true. Average business loss is $7,900 per minute. All right. Copper at a 99.9% availability, which is the standard, you're looking at 8.7 hours of downtime, 4 million in losses. Optical LAN with one OLT, five nines, goes to 5 minutes, down to 39,000, and you can have what's called OLT redundancy. What that means is you have one OLT in one building, one in another, they both plug into the network, one watches the other, gets you down to 30 seconds, or $3,950 in losses. So you go from a possible 4 million in losses, 3,900 in losses for a less expensive network. Here's another myth. This is the redundancy part. Basically explaining that. This shows one building on building two, both plug into the same splitter, one watches the other, and it cuts over in a few seconds. Diverse rings if you want, dual homes. Again, just expanding on that. Here we go, one watching, primary OT is serving. Talk back. Okay, they basically just sit there and wait, the second OLT. Oh, there's your brake. Traffic stops. Back, the backup, they notice a lack of traffic, cuts it over, picks up right away. Just a few seconds, less than 3 seconds, this all happens. 3 seconds of downtime. Centralized management, another advantage. Again, campus environment, large hotel, one OLT can do it 20 to 30 kilometers away. Copper would require a switch at every single building with fiber backbones. They say GPON is bandwidth is limited because of network capacity is inferior. Again, not true. You can do 101 terabits of fiber now on a single mode fiber. Go from 10 megabits to 100 gigabits with the infrastructure. All you have to do is swap out your end equipment. So very secure, very upgradable, very resilient. No, a little goof there. They say GPONs are dumb. Again, no, they're not dumb. GPONs, they don't store user information. However, you can use make monitoring control, access control lists. They do support VLANs. Again, 8 VLANs per port. They say it doesn't provide Ethernet service. Again, not true. 802.3 standards is what PLL supplies. They say operation and maintenance is more complicated. Well, that's not actually true either because everything is plug and play. And you can what you can do is you can go on an iPad or a phone and you can look at your network and you can find out where in the network you have a break. You don't have to go to the switch in the building. You don't have to go across town or wherever or across the campus. You can do it right from your laptop. Very easy to use. Doesn't support power over Ethernet. Again, not true. ONTs do support PoE. The one thing that people always talk about when you have an ONT is you do have to have a power supply next to your ONT. You can do PoE. You can also install an extra power port. The cost to install a power port for your ONTs is far less than the cost that you save, the money you save year over year. So it's less money in the long run. They say you need to change out splitters to add users. No, you don't. You just plug it in, the OLT reads it, and it syncs up with the ONT, and you're off and running, unless you want to introduce security, which you can do after the fact. Very easy to use. So you add the first splitter, and then two, three, and four can be added later. They say fiber is more fragile. Again, not true. Look at the fiber there. It used to be that case 10, 15 years ago, not anymore. very resilient. They say a forklift upgrade is required if you want to go to a GPON system. No. 2.4 gig to 10 gig, again, single card replacement for new GPON users. And they're also, like I said before, on a different set of wavelengths. You can have simultaneous networks, 2.4 gig and 10 gig, on your POL. Doesn't support power users, not true again, 2.4 gigs. You name one device that is not going to be able to, that is going to be able to handle 2.4 gigs. That's a lot of bandwidth to work with. Doesn't support security, again, AES 128 encryption, layer 2.3 access control, per port, per service, VLANs, it's all there for you. Here's the one that a lot of contractors hit me with. It's going to ruin the cabling business. Because POL is less expensive to install than a copper network, a lot of the contractors always say, well, now how am I going to go sell networks? Here's the thing, like it or not, POL is coming, and there are going to be more people able to upgrade their networks because this cost is so much less than a copper network. So you have a more pool of customers to shoot from. Okay, so more people are going to be able to afford to do a POL versus copper. This is a very compelling case study. So it's a cruise ship in Italy. Because they chose POL, they saved 1 million pounds of copper weight, and they were able to add 50 extra cabins on the ship for a network that is less money, less space. So 1,000 per week per cabin, we'll say, 52 weeks per year, 52,000 weeks or per cabin per year, that's 2.6 million in extra revenue per year because they chose POL. Oh, and by the way, it was built for half the cost of a copper network. And it's cost less to run as well. This is a revenue projection for those who manage hotels or buildings. Per night, you can kind of see the possibilities there depending on how many rooms you save. So the low end, 125 a night, you're going to be about another $500,000 annually. The bottom, you're going to be about 3.2 in other rooms. Does installation cost the same?
Yes.
Installation is actually less because you have less material to deal with. If you're going from a bundle of cables like that to one about the size of a pinky or a pencil, much less. Yeah, much, much less. This is the largest PON installation in the world. This is Sandia Labs, 256 buildings. They're going to save $20 million over 5 years. They're going to reduce their energy costs by 65%. It's all managed from a single OLT, about that size, the entire thing. They went from serving 900 users, requiring 3 double ovens, to 8,000 users with a microwave size oven. And they recycled $80,000 in their copper. And they're set for 25 years. If they were to go with copper, they'd have to replace it every 5 to 8 years is about the standard. Another case study. This is Arch Cardinal Cook Healthcare in New York. 2,300 users, reduced capital by 38%, increased data ports by 400%, reduced power by 20%, reclaimed IDF space, improved LAN performance. This is an intelligence community. 2,500 users. 1,000 foot square foot reduction in riser space, 65% reduction in capital equipment, and then 32.8 kilowatt reduction in their system power requirements. And these are the markets that POL is going after right now: education, healthcare, government, hospitality, commercial, stadiums, cruise ships, of course, with the compelling cruise ship argument. Any questions? All right.
Very good, Jim.
Oh, thanks. Good.